Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for January to March 2016. El Niño is near its peak and will break down in the new year. Historically, this has meant above average rain closer to autumn. But heatwave and bushfire risks are raised in any El Niño summer. First, let's look at recent conditions. Spring was the second warmest on record for Australia. In fact, our last three springs have been the warmest three on record. After a very dry September and October, Australia's rainfall in November was actually 2 millimetres above average. Most of this rain fell in the first 10 days of the month. There are some early indications of the monsoon forming to the north of Australia, so its onset may not be far away. Typically, the Australian monsoon arrives around Christmas. Despite the November rains, drought continues in many parts of the country. Areas of short-term rainfall deficiency are now widespread. Long-term deficiencies, over 3 years, can now be seen in every state and the Northern Territory. The rain has left lower layer soil moisture looking healthier in many areas, with the exception of some key southern agricultural regions. Heat and low rainfall for spring as a whole have already led to major bushfires in southern states. Historically, the combination of El Niño and a positive Indian Ocean dipole in spring tends to raise the bushfire potential for summer. After a relatively poor southern filling season, we go into summer with many water storages less than half full, and at lower levels than at this time last year. So what's driving Australia's climate right now? This year's strong El Niño is near its peak and is highly likely to ease during the first quarter of 2016. This event ranks in the top three El Niños of the past 50 years. El Niño impacts already being felt around the globe include significant droughts for some of our Pacific neighbours, severe tropical cyclones in the northern Pacific, and floods in South America. For Australia, other key climate drivers are in play. As forecast, the Indian Ocean Dipole has returned to neutral and won't affect our climate again until at least mid-2016. But record warmth in the Indian Ocean is likely to feed extra moisture towards Australia. So what's the outlook for January to March 2016? Most stronger El Niños have seen some wetter periods near their end. Odds favour above average rainfall in southeast Queensland and southern Tasmania. But rainfall is likely to be below average in the southeast and across northern Australia. Our rainfall outlook has high accuracy at this time of year. Turning to the streamflow forecast for December to February, low flows are more likely at 59 of 96 locations. 30 sites have near median flows forecast, and only 7 are likely to have high flows. Accuracy for our streamflow forecast is high at this time of year. Temperature outlooks show warmer than average days and nights likely in the north, but cooler than usual in parts of the southeast. Accuracy for these outlooks is moderate at this time of year. After poor spring rains and early heat, bushfire risk is high, so if you're camping over summer, take care. Likewise, heatwaves remain likely. Keep an eye on our heatwave service if you're spending a lot of time outdoors. So in summary, El Niño is likely to ease in early 2016. Odds favour average to above average summer rainfall in parts of eastern Australia, but drier than usual conditions in the north. Low stream flows are likely in most places. Bushfire and heatwave risk is raised during El Niño summers. For more details, head to our website at bomb.gov.au/climate/ahead. You can also follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Our next video will be released on Thursday, the 28th of January. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Andrew Watkins.